Dr. Smith, First Lady, officers, members, friends, and our distinguished guests. As we continue our Black History Moment for the month of February, it is both a privilege and a pleasure to introduce our speaker for today. Mrs. Sandra Simmons is a dynamic facilitator and diversity trainer with more than 20 years of experience in human service and EEO. A seasoned diversity expert, Mrs. Simmons has provided training for federal agencies, local municipalities, and nonprofit agencies. Ms. Simmons is a mediator certified by the Atlanta Justice Center and Department of Veterans Affairs. She currently serves as the EAS, Envoy for Equal Employment Opportunity Commission, EEOC, and the CEO of Insight Resources Limited, and president of the Nonprofit Women's League for Minority Education. Her education involves being certified mediator by the Atlanta Justice Center. She has a master's in social work from Jane Addams, a school of social work, University of Illinois, and a Bachelor of Arts, Sociology, John C. Smith. As we continue our Black History Moment for the month of February, we realize that she is a lady who is about the people's business, caring, compassionate, and a no-nonsense are but a few of the descriptions that best describe her. Individual lives have become better because of her. It is an honor for me to have the opportunity to introduce Ms. Sandra Simmons.
Why didn't I know about those three ladies?
Yeah.
Jackson, Dorothy Bonds, or Mary Jackson. Yet the space shuttle showed up with the landing and handed it to those three women. But there has been and continues to be a deliberate attempt to deny, minimize, and erase the positive contributions of black people. And Carter G. Woodson, when he said he wanted to create a Black History Week that was extended to a month, he was a wise man because he knew the contributions of black people needed to be recognized. And we've done a lot. When you wake up in the morning until you go to bed at night, the accomplishments of black people impact your day. Let me just name a few of these things that black people are responsible for bringing into your life. The ironing board, the iron, the hair comb, the hairbrush, the dustpan, the mop, the clothes dryer, the pencil sharpener, the fountain pen, the lawnmower, the automatic airship, the combustion engine, the refrigerator, the heating furnace, the drop mailbox, the postmarking and canceling machine when you mail a letter, the electronic trolley if you ride it in Philadelphia, the filament for the light bulb, and the list goes on and on. Think how many times a day you use those things. The other myth I want to clarify is we are a strong, smart, creative, business savvy, hardworking, spiritual people. Not the weak, feeble-minded, criminal-minded image so often portrayed in the media. There is someone included in the 1% who sits in the White House who talks about givers and takers and describes us as the takers. Poor soul, he lacks knowledge. He does not know that black Americans represent 44.5 million people. And if we were a nation, we would be the 15th wealthiest nation. With a gross national income of $836 billion. The poor soul, he doesn't know. He talks about the military, but he doesn't know. The personal sacrifices blacks have made for this country. No one shared with him that we represent only 12% of the population, but we're 17% of the military. Yeah. Because of time, and Dana told me to do a Black History moment, I'm only going to do five Americans to substantiate how smart we are as a people. And I'm going to pick five that may be hidden figures. You already know about Garrett Morgan, Oprah Winfrey, Charles Drew, Thurgood Marshall, Colin Powell, Condoleezza Rice. So I'm not going to talk about those people. Let me ask you, who is the first African-American woman to own a billion-dollar company? She was a millionaire. This is a billionaire. The person is Janice Bryan. And she was born on September the 1st in 1952 in Tabor, North Carolina. She is the CEO of the Act One Group, which is a human resource firm, talent hunt that find talents for Fortune 5 companies. But I'm gonna tell you a little bit about her story. She said she integrated the school in Tabor, North Carolina, and when she sat in the class as the only black, the teacher talked about blacks can't do anything but serve. She said, I frequently bit the inside of my jaw because the negative talking was so negative about what black people could do. She said, I left determined that I was going to prove her wrong. And prove her wrong, she did. Yeah. Yeah. Let me ask you, who was the co-pilot in flight number 93 that crashed in Shanksville? 9/11, there was a black man in that as the co-pilot, named Leroy Homer. They just made him an honorary Tuskegee Airman. Let me ask you about a toy that our kids frequently play with called the Super Soaker. My son made one. That toy was designed by a black man named Leon Johnson. He was a NASA engineer and a former Air Forceman. That every year that Super Soaker makes the best toy list. Now let me tell you about a woman named Mildred Jeter. There was a time interracial marriages were against the law. If you married someone outside of your race, you could be arrested.
Oh, you're good.
She married Richard Loving.
Should have told me to move.
That's all right. Now tell me. You were clear.
To rule that interracial marriages could not be illegal anymore. Credit to Mildred Jeter. Little current stuff. Ryan Cooler, only 31 years old from Oakland. Go to see that movie, Black Panther. A black superhero. What a creative idea. We've been harboring Superman for a long time. There are so many more examples, but I'm going to stop here because I want to leave you with some challenges. Number one, what can we do to make things better? What can you do to make things better? Number one, we can pray. The Bible says, if my people who are called by my name shall humble themselves, pray, seek my face and turn from their wicked ways, then I will honor, you will hear from heaven and will heal their land. Lord knows our land is healed. So let's pray. That's the first thing we can do. The next thing we can do, we can support black businesses and black churches. I don't know about you, but I hear so many people say, oh, I'm the only black in that church. I'm the only black in this position. It's no pride in saying I'm the only. Support others so that you won't be the only. And we can support black businesses. I'm reminded of a story. It said there was a black man who sold ice. And he had a profitable business. But when a white man noticed that he was making so much money in his business, the white man said, I'm gonna start selling some ice. So then, when he started selling ice, the black man customers left him and started buying ice from the white man. So then, the black man said, what are you doing that? I'm going over here and ask Tom, what is the reason why these black folks leaving me and buying ice from the white man? Tom said, well, I just have to tell you, the white man ice is cooler. A funny story, yes. But it's reflective of an attitude that has to change. If we are to be prosperous, we need to support each other. Third, we need to vote. Amen. 44 million blacks. We have voting power. We now know we can make a difference in most elections. Ask Roy Moore what happened to him in Alabama. It was because black folks came out and voted. Next, we need to support the civil rights organization that stood by us during the rough times. Such as the NAACP, Urban League, CORE. If you don't belong, Please join. With unity, there is strength. Next, number five, we need to support historically black colleges and universities. There were 116. Today, there are only 107, located in 19 states, the District of Columbia, and the U.S. Virgin Islands. These colleges continue to produce the most African-American doctors, lawyers, and engineers. We need to preserve them. Now, in closing, I'm going to say Sankofa. This is a word in the language of Ghana that translates to go back and get it. San means to return, ko is to go, and fa is to fetch. It refers to a mythical bird symbol of the Afghan people in Ghana. This mystical bird has its feet planted firmly on the ground, and it flies forward. As it flies forward, its head is looking backwards. It carries an egg in its mouth to symbolize the future, reminding us of the importance of looking back to move forward. Let's keep looking back to keep the valuable things that are at risk of being left behind as we move forward as a people. I thank you for allowing me this opportunity to share with you for your Black History Month. I trust that we will keep looking